The Philippine government vows to release 100 million pesos to help residents of Dinagat Islands rebuild houses that Typhoon Oded smashed to the ground last week. According to Malacañang, President Duterte instructed the National Housing Authority to provide the funds in a visit to the southern province Wednesday. Acting presidential spokesperson Carlo Nograles says this is on top of the cash aid and food packs that Duterte directed the Social Welfare Department to give residents. He adds the Department of Energy will ensure the delivery of gasoline and other petroleum products to the Dinagat Islands.
The death toll from Odette continues to rise. 258 fatalities have been reported to the National Disaster Risk Reduction Management and Management Council, but only 11 have been verified so far. Over 560 people were also injured. 47 were reported missing. Damage to infrastructure was estimated at 2.5 billion pesos. The Philippine government has declared a state of calamity in six regions affected by the typhoon. Odette is the strongest storm to hit the Philippines this year, but its true scale of destruction remains unclear, with several regions still isolated.
Over in Bohol, the typhoon death toll now stands at 103. 12 people remain missing. The situation also remains dire for survivors a week after the storm passed. Bohol Governor Arthur Yap says around 200,000 families are still in need of help.
Yung pagkain talaga ngayon, kailangan mag-distribute tayo. Kaya nga sabi ko nga, kung nahihirapan yung DSWD for logistics reason dahil ang daming natamaan, pati ang Cebu natamaan, and all shipments are coming just from Manila, baka mas mabuti vice na mag-download na lang sila sa mga gobernador kahit na tagte 20 to 30 million just to begin with.
The Philippine Labor Department rolls out its emergency employment program to help residents in areas hit by Typhoon Odette. Some 25,000 informal sector workers across six regions will be tasked to deliver and repack relief goods and clear roads for some 15 to 90 days. 100 million pesos has been allocated for the program. The agency also plans to use a portion of its 2022 budget to further boost the funds for it.
Filipino-Chinese business groups donate funds for relief efforts in typhoon-hit areas. Almost 1 million pesos worth of cash assistance has been raised in the donation drive. The initiative was led by the Anvil Business Club, participated by organizations such as the Tu Chi Foundation. They say this is just the first of a series of donations to help victims rebuild their lives after their homes and livelihood were devastated by Typhoon Odette.
We still have donations coming in as we speak. So once we get more allocations, we will identify some more partners and organizations that would help us distribute. All Anvil wants right now is to for our friends in the south to have a good Christmas man lang, no? So as much as we can, we want them to we want to be able to help in our own way.
The Philippine Coast Guard also chipping in to help the victims of Odette. Members of the PCG District Western Visayas used their own money to buy nearly 100 gallons of drinking water for affected families in Cebu. This as access to clean water remains a problem in Cebu and other typhoon-hit areas. Meanwhile, a Coast Guard ship has also delivered 2,000 liters of gasoline and 16 portable generator sets to Cebu.
More countries are sending donations to fast-track recovery efforts in typhoon-hit areas. Canada has allocated $50,000 as an initial response to the most affected communities in the Caraga region. The funding will facilitate the delivery of much-needed humanitarian aid. The Embassy of Israel, meanwhile, has sent food packs, hygiene kits, and water purifiers to victims of Typhoon Odette in Bohol and Cebu. Solar energy systems were also sent to typhoon-hit residents. The National Grid Corporation of the Philippines says it has restored around 70% to 75% of the 95 transmission lines affected by Typhoon Odette. It says the storm damaged over 12 transmission towers and over 600 transmission poles in Visayas and Mindanao. It stresses the importance of local governments supporting its transmission projects.
And I'd really like to take this opportunity to explain why NGCP's transmission projects are important and that the local government officials should support this. Because, you know, we've been trying to finish these projects, but we are there are difficulties with the at the local level. So if should these interconnection and looping projects have pushed through on time, then there would have been redundancies and alternative paths and restoration would be easy.
Meanwhile, the Energy Regulatory Commission orders power industry players to fast-track the restoration of their services in typhoon-hit areas. It also instructed power utility companies and electric cooperatives to relax payment collection rules for customers affected by the typhoon.
Kasama doon sa i-direct namin sa mga distribution utilities na pag-relax sa kanilang collection policy ay siyempre yung hindi muna pagpapatupad ng agad-agarang disconnection sa mga kababayan natin na naapektuhan ng bagyo na hindi makakabayad on time.